Welcome to another episode of Pablo Live. I'm your host, Pablo. Let's see what we have in this episode for you.
Even put the decorations at the end where he said it's high time. I said hi to you, back to me, the pen holder. I am here perambulating at this moment. That's apoka, you know. Then you put dedications. When you think about love, think about me by Celine Dion featuring Raga D.
You know, my friend, because you're a policeman, you think that you can stand there and talk to me here? I'll do it to you here. I'll send you to a bloody fool. Tower.
Some pastors who perform miracles, they throw blessings, everybody falls apart from the cameraman. Yes, and I know that they're also here in Uganda, eh? So I still try to go in that side. But people have also mastered how to deal with them. One time there was a pastor, he was throwing blessings. Hallelujah! You know, they didn't care to pastors. They're those who preach as if it's a rap. Yo, man, I want to tell you, man, Jesus loves you. You go to hear about Jesus, going to be, those ones are appealing to the youth. It depends on your target audience. If the church is full of people who love music, you do it. Hallelujah, want to tell you, man, Jesus loves you. Sing with me, hallelujah. So that depends on what your target audience. If it's the Mothers Union and all those other unions, no, the someone is best on remembrance, there's no hope. No. One time, there was a young man. The young man was watching TV. And he saw this pastor throwing blessings. Hallelujah! But the man was falling. The man said, this is the church to visit. So one Sunday, he went and attended the church. And that day, it was a deliverance Sunday. So they were delivering, exercising demons. So the pastor preached and said, hallelujah! He was a Uganda pastor, but he was an international Muganda. Because he preached in Luganda and had to interpret it in Luganda. It's the same thing, same language, but the accent. So, at some point, the pastor said, hallelujah, hallelujah. If you have a demon, if you have a demon, if you have something disturbing, yo, come forth. If you have a demon now. That my friend was watching the TV, attended that service, he said, this is the demon.
Get up!
I think you had a demon. They said, demon, get out! He said, no! No!
Demon, break loose!
No! No! So the pastor said, what do you want, demon? What do you want?
I want bread.
They say, bring bread. They got the man buns. Now, buns? Buns, I don't want to call buns. Buns are just buns, eh? That bread, that is round, buns. They give it at starters in hotels, but small size. Now, this one was from a shop, three sizes. The man ate the bun, but because it was burning,
no!
But I said, demon, get down! Said,
no!
What? Escort, something to bring. The pastor said, bring water! The demon said,
no, soda!
It was the demon with a choice.
Soda!
He said, bring soda! They gave the demon soda! The man was enjoying and spent 3 days without eating. The pastor said, get out! He
said, no!
What?
Sausage!
The pastor looked around, sausage! Where do we get sausage? The pastor said, no, this demon is expensive. Asha, preach up, we need to find the demon! Let's get the demon! When the man had a market, he said, hallelujah! I'm healed. The pastor looked at him and said, yes, I know the demon has gone, but we need to
guy in our primary school. He was, I don't know whether he was daft or he was just stubbornly giving weird answers. Whichever subject you came with, he had always a weird answer to give. From mathematics, the teacher comes and asks, class, if 5 people can clear a bush in 2 days, how long will it take 10 people to clear the same bush? He gets up. Since 5 people have cleared the bush, the 10 will just collect the rubbish and go away. I realized when I was back in school, that it was easier to get a relationship in secondary school than primary. In secondary school, all you needed to do was to know how to write a letter. These letters that you wrote, you even put dedications at the end where you say, it's high time, I said hi to you, back to me, the pen holder, I am here perambulating at this moment, that's apoka, you know? Then you put dedications, when you think about love, think about me, by Celine Dion featuring Raga D, you know, those dedications. In primary, I learned that to get a girl, to get a relationship, depends on 2 factors. Either you had to be a guy, a kid from a rich family, or you had to be bright. Now, there was a girl in our school called Bena. Everybody, she was beautiful. Everybody wanted her from the class monitor, class teacher, other DC, DPO, Ascari. Everybody wanted this young girl. But she had, I think she liked me. She liked me. I think she liked me, but we were 2 guys competing. One rich guy, one loaded guy, then me, the bright guy. I was always bright in class, bright from nursery. I was so bright in nursery, they wanted to retain me as a lecturer. So, I was bright. So, Palazzo would go to Ben and say, Ben, if you accept me, I will give you breakfast and lunch every day. I went to her like, Ben, you accept me, I'll give you answers in class. Now, because in our school, I was Chivoko, she had to choose me for answers. I was in P3, but I started doing research in library. I read books. Good thing my dad was a politician, so he had those heavy books, encyclopedia, you know, Good News Bible, you know, Chogam Report, you know, Land Title, all those heavy books. So I learned heavy terminology, those big words from my father's books. So one time the teacher comes and asks a question. No one knew the answer. But then they were used. Every time they would ask a question, nobody would raise their hand. I would raise their hand. Teacher's like, Emma, you put down your hand. For you know, let others answer. You know? It would happen that way. So that was the norm. Then one day she came with a question. No one knew the answer. P3, she asked, class, what is climate? No one knew the answer. I didn't know the answer, but I knew. I put down my hand and they tell me put it down. Indeed, I put it up. The teacher said, Emma, for you, you know, put down your hand. I put down and say, oh. The teacher looked around, no one knew the answer. She said, Emma, what about you tell them? Oh. Now, in the definition of climate, I only knew one word, average. Climate is the word average. So I fumbled. Climate is average so in the place. She asked, class, have you heard? Teacher, no. Emma, repeat. Oh. Since she was a student teacher, I decided to just confuse with the terminology. I rapped. Climate is the average modernization of constitutional affairs caused by epidemic crisis in the diaspora. She looked around and said, very good, clap for him. And then clap.
Time is coming, you shall hear something. Jesus is coming, he's shining, hey. All angels singing, and God's setting him, saying, go, hallelujah, Jesus is coming. Oh, my time, the time is coming, you shall hear.
killing you?
Angriness. Anger.
What's the problem?
I'm dead. I was going to drop out.
No.
No. No.
No. You can't get out of school. What's your problem? Yay.
Our teacher is so confusing. He's confusing me.
Hey, hey, calm down. What's the problem?
Our teacher is just so confusing. Mm. On Monday, he told us that 8 plus 2 is 10. Mm-hmm. Now on yesterday, he told us 5 plus 5 is 10. And today, he has just told us that 7 plus 3 is 10. Why can't he just make up his mind?
When there's a riot, what if there's no riot? They are good. They are quiet. When there's a riot, you don't see them. When there's no riot, they are the riot. So we riot with them every day. Let me give you an instance. You know, the only reason we respect them is because of how they are. Because here they say the riot, they shoot rubber bullets. In our own, they don't just shoot real bullets, they plant bomb for you. If I'm lying, let somebody say so. Policeman in Nigeria, you respect him for only one reason. Not for his rank, you respect him because of his slap. When a policeman slaps you, you will know that your wickedest neighbor is a good man. Because when a civilian has an argument with a civilian and the other civilian insults the first civilian, the result is a slap and then a fight. Like this, let me show you. Let's imagine now, just use your brain for once. Imagine now that there is a civilian here. I'm a civilian and we're arguing. And I'm like, my friend, let me tell you, there's nothing you can do. I'll deal with you now, idiot. Immediately I say idiot. What follows? Slap. You are an idiot. Stand by. This is what you see from a civilian. You slap me. You slap me. We'll die here today. I'll kill you. What you see is fight. Civilian and civilian. Now, in the context of Nigerian police, civilian and police, when a policeman slaps you, first of all, your anger will die down. You will recognize him as a policeman. Then you go into explanation that he did not ask you for. This is what I mean. This is police, I'm civilian. My friend, because you're a policeman, you think that you can stand there and talk to me here, I'll deal with you here. I'll send you like a bloody fool. Tower! Officer. The police is your friend. How can we move this country forward without dialogue? Because if you ask me, I would have told you that this boy was coming here now. At that time, I was here. Honestly, you see, you're explaining. And they never asked you for explanation. That is police. Now, there are this set of people we call the MOPO, mobile police. It's in Nigeria's SWAT team. I don't know what you call their own here. Rapid response, thank you. That even the slap is rapid response. These ones that do press up, not with all the fingers, three fingers at a time. When they slap you, you don't have time to cool down or recognize anything wrong. You just go straight into explanation with a particular kind of voice, a very familiar voice. Let me show you what I mean. This is Mopo, that's rapid response, Nigerian version. My friend, I'll deal with you. You thought that you come here and start doing all this, I'll deal with you. I'll show you who I am in this country because you're a bloody fool. Don't lie! This boy was coming from here.
Watch Pablo Live Comedy Show. Now we've come to the end of this episode, but remember you can always follow the fan on our YouTube channel, that is Pablo Comedian Uganda, or you can also like our Facebook page, that's Pablo Live Yagayo, and the happiness continues.